You still couldn't believe that this was actually happening. Like, we heard, you know, months ago that, oh, there's this program that you can get into, you find the Bahama Comet in Texas. We thought that'd be the coolest thing on Earth, but it's not possible. So it was really hard to actually hit home that we're actually gonna do this.
First got on the plane, I was pretty excited. Yeah.
I was feeling a little nervous, you bet. I didn't know if I was gonna be the world record setter for vomiting on the plane, but I didn't have a problem with that.
This morning, I was definitely feeling a little bit nervous, but very excited. It was everything and more that I could have expected. You know, being in zero gravity is just like something that's really difficult to describe.
Kind of reminded me a little bit of going over a hill when I was a kid. My dad used to drive fast over the tops of these little hills, and we'd catch a little bit of zero G or action there. But it was sustained. Just kept going, and it also kind of pushed us up toward the ceiling a little bit, maybe a little bit of negative G. It was great. Jesse did a couple of somersault flips, and Kevin was floating inverted, and actually doing inverted while he was still doing science, I think.
Kind of like float a little bit, and you kind of feel that lurch in your stomach, or you're on a roller coaster, and you go over the top of the big drop, and it's just like this unbelievable fun feeling. And then being able to actually do that for an extended period of time was really amazing.
The first parabola is completely disorienting. Like, you're sitting there and then you're laying down because it's heavy 2G, and you come out and you go forward, your legs are above your head, you're trying to grab things, the whole plane looks like it's moving, and you're like, what? You have no idea what's going on.
Difficult to control. You try and you're floating upwards, and you try and stop floating upwards by holding onto a bar, but your feet keep on going upwards, and then you don't know how to get your feet back down to the ground because you can't touch anything to get them back down, and kicking doesn't help at all. So it's a really cool and fun experience for sure.
Well, it's weightless. You just go up there, no effort. You just kind of float around. You grab something. You can just turn. Just basically a flick of wrist, and you can do whatever you want.
You just lay back during the 2-gravity portion and just kind of relax, and you feel your face kind of be pulled, just like, whoa, and then you come back and then you're floating, and it's just like, all right.
This experiment focused mainly on preventing water from getting stuck inside of equipment like the one that's up on space station. And this experiment went really well. I'm very impressed with the team. They did a good job engineering. They performed well. They were excellent.
Now we go back and we look at conservation of momentum, conservation of energy, and kind of determine whether this super hydrophobic material would work for pipe coatings and different things where we're trying to recover all the water in space.
We're extremely fortunate and blessed to actually have this opportunity and be able to fly on this aircraft, see what zero gravity feels like, run an experiment. It's something that's never been done before. It's just such an amazing experience.